Pope John Paul II wrote Mulieris Dignatatem, and part of a reason for writing this is to recognize the importance and dignity of women in the church and society and what it truly means to be a woman or a man. It is also the Marian year, so JP2 thought it was a good opportunity to expand on the dignity and vocation of women using Mary as the perfect model. Man and woman are created equally in God's image and likeness. They are the apex of creation to which God entrusted dominion over all the earth. Man and woman are a unity of two. They exist for each other. Each person must strive for self-realization through a sincere gift of self. From the beginning, man and woman corrupted the mutual relationship God had planned, and they abused the call to share in the intimate life of God Himself. Man would now have to toil, and woman would suffer in childbirth. In original sin, as the mutual relationship God intended is tarnished, the male dominance over the woman ensues. God spoke to women to intervene in the history of His people. Jesus encountered women all the time and treated them with dignity and respect. He spoke to them as equals and defended them. Jesus also healed many women and did favors for them, something society back then just did not do. Every man who looks lustfully at another woman commits adultery in his heart. Here, Jesus is showing men that women are not objects of their own desire. This is one of the many beautiful examples of Jesus respecting the dignity of women. Women were more loyal and proved stronger than the apostles during Jesus' crucifixion. Women were also the first for a lot of his revelations. Christ entrusts divine truths to women. Women and men are equal and both receive revelations and so-called visits. So therefore, the vocation of women also consists of witnessing the mighty works of God. There are two dimensions of the female vocation. One, motherhood, and two, virginity. They coexist and marry perfectly. The interior readiness of a mother is a special openness to the new person. As the father remains outside the experience, he has to learn fatherhood from the mother, which is part of the mutual relationship. The woman has to suffer for the child, therefore the man owes a special debt to the woman. Celibacy for the sake of the kingdom is called to a particular person by God. Their desires are offered for the kingdom of God. It is another vocation for women other than marriage. They realize their femininity and dignity in their sincere gift of self for God. A woman becomes one spirit with Christ the spouse. Consecrated women express spiritual motherhood in their care for the community and the needy. The interior readiness for motherhood is open to all people for these women. Jesus is the bridegroom of the church, and the church is the bride. Just as Jesus died for the church, must a husband be willing to sacrifice his life for his wife. Christ desires his bride, the church, to be without spot or wrinkle. This is how Jesus respected the dignity of women. This is how men should act towards women. Sincere gift of self. Subjection is mutual in a man-woman relationship. With his freedom in that he did everything, Christ chose men to be his apostles. These apostles alone received the sacramental institution of the Eucharist and the Holy Spirit to forgive sins. Therefore, men are called as priests. With this, the Eucharist is Christ's redemptive act toward his bride, the Church, and is therefore performed by men. A woman's dignity is connected with the love she receives and returns. A woman can discover herself in giving love to others. The woman is an example of struggling to say yes or no to your vocation. A woman is strong because of her awareness of the importance of God entrusting a human being to her. Also, men have lost sensitivity, so that sensitivity genius rests mainly in the woman. So if you still didn't understand any of that, basically, Mulieris Dignitatem states that women are awesome and the church recognizes it and they don't discriminate against women.